Hi Harpers, Tiffany here, bringing you another Tune Tutor where we learn traditional tunes in the traditional way by ear. Today I'm going to teach you a Scottish tune called Drummond Castle, and this is listed in a lot of places as a jig, but I'm going to teach it to you the way I learned it, which is in more of a march style. We have to do a Scottish tune today because this weekend is the Ohio Scottish Games, which I am super excited about. And I'm going to try and take you guys along and maybe film some footage, maybe some Facebook Live videos if I can get that to work. I usually compete in the harp competition. This year my husband and I are doing a set together on harp and bow run, so I hope to have a video of that for you guys once it's over. The video for next week will be late. It won't be on a Friday. It will probably be uploaded on a Saturday, and that's because I will be gone at the Ohio Scottish Arts School this week. So I am hoping to also do some vlogging while I'm there and kind of show you guys what it's like and what you're missing if you have never been. So that should be up on next Saturday. So be sure and subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss the videos to come. Also pop down in the comments any other tunes you would like me to teach. Hopefully I'll bring back some good ones from the Ohio Scottish Art School this year. So without further ado, let's get to the lesson. Okay, this tune is in the key of C. Actually, it's in A minor. So no levers if you're tuned in C. Everything is natural, except if you want to do a little ornament that I like to do, this high F should be sharp. But otherwise, you can leave that out if you don't have levers or if you don't have F levers. It's fine without it too. So I'm gonna play the tune first and then we'll go through it. Okay, as I said, this is in 6/8, but I play it in more of a march style rather than a jig. I'm going to have the sheet music down below in the description, so that can guide you too. We're gonna start on this A. If you have larger hands, or if you have a Celtic harp, a true Celtic harp, where the strings are quite close together, you should be able to place your fingerings ahead of time so you don't miss that high jump to the high A. So after we do this part, just an A octave, A, B, and A octave, you're going to hit the A again. And what I like to do is hit this A hit this F sharp on the way, so it sounds like this. It's just a little grace note. You could also leave it out. And next, you're going to be on this C, and you can do a trill here. You can either do that with these three fingers, 4-3-2, or you can do it with 3-2-1. And I have another video where I talked about this, but in case you haven't seen that one, all I'm doing is hitting this string three times in a row with three different fingers. And if you practice it that way and just try and get faster and faster, the emphasis will come on the first finger you use. So finger three is the one that really drives it. The other two can be lighter. Okay, so from the beginning. Okay, I'll do that again. A trill here. And that should be easy if you think of it as this is just a G chord. You're just starting on the B, going up, going back down. So from the trill on the C, it sounds like this. G chord. Now we're starting over. Now you're on this E. Skipping the C on the way down. Okay, that is the entire A part, and you play that through twice. So I'm going to do the whole thing without any breaks, slowly. G chord. Skip the C. Again. You'll notice that the A part can be broken down into halves or even fourths. Okay, so there's one half, there's the second half, and then you just repeat that. Now we're going to learn the B part. So once you've landed on this A, you're going to crawl up to this C. Okay, we'll try that again. The next part goes, you can also do a trill again. Same thing as the beginning, that G chord. So that again is. All the way up to the A. Now we're going back down. And again, we skip that C on the way down. So it ends a lot like the A part. We'll do the B part again. That was the first half. Now again, we're starting on C. That's the second half of the B part. So let's play the B part again without any interruptions, slowly. Thank you. again. The chords that go with this, so you can make up your own arrangement. Okay, so from the A part, that is obviously an A minor chord. You could do a G chord there. So here's the change. G. Now you're on C, G, E minor goes well there, so you're at a G, E minor, back to A minor, G, C, G, E minor. Back to A minor. Let's try that again. A minor, G, C, G, E minor, A minor, G, C, G, E minor. Now for the B part, you're going to start on a C chord in the left. And then a G. A minor. G. E minor. Back to C. G. That's an F chord. Now you're at A minor, G, E minor, A minor. There's a lot of chords in this, but it's a lot of the same chords over and over again. So if this seems hard to you, don't be discouraged. We'll do the B part again, starting with the C chord. Then a G. A minor, G, back to C, F, A minor, G, E minor, A minor. Now, if you're a beginner and all these chords are just too notey for you and it just seems really daunting, try and, first of all, write in the chords, print out the sheet music that's in the description, write the chord symbols on top of it, and you can either just do triads for the chords, you could also do fifths. Or you can also just do one note. So whatever chord that is, just play that note. So, if you're just playing one note in the left hand, it would sound like this. Totally doable with some practice.
Thanks so much for learning this tune with me, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, please give it a like and a share on your Facebook page or with your friends. It helps me out a lot. And be sure and subscribe if you haven't already. Go ahead and send me a message through my email or on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. If you have any questions or any tunes you would like to learn, I love getting in touch with you. And thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next week on Saturday.